Now we have what might seem to be a daunting task of fully defining all the standard lines on the sketch, but it's actually a reasonably simple task. All the black lines are fully defined and the blue lines are underdefined. Another way to confirm this is to highlight one of the black lines and then look at the property manager. You can see the vertical relation that was added to the line, and below that you can see it's fully defined. You can add relations to the line using the options in this section, but since the line is fully defined, there's no need to do this. You can also change the line to a construction line or an infinite line. The infinite line is rarely used because there are usually faster ways of drawing lines. You can draw an infinite line and then trim it later to suit your needs. We're going to make the top line on the sketch a construction line, so highlight the line and then change it to a construction line. Construction lines look like center lines, and that's essentially what they are. They can be used as center lines for dimensions, and they can be used for the axis of revolution in revolve operations. Zoom into the 1/8 inch dimension and I'll show you what I mean. Delete the dimension, highlight it, and then type the delete key. Now type the D key to evoke the smart dimension command. Notice that the vertical line turned blue, indicating that it's no longer fully defined. Select the line, and then select the construction line. When your pointer is on the right side of the construction line, the dimension is a standard dimension. Move your pointer to the left side, and it becomes a diametral dimension. You just need to move your pointer to the opposite side of the standard line to create a diametral dimension. Go ahead and create this dimension. Now that the line is fully defined again, let's work on the rest of the lines. You don't have to start with the lines that are next to the fully defined lines, but it does help to do this. Lines that are surrounded by underdefined lines can move significantly when you add relations or dimensions. So when one end of the line is grounded with a fully defined line, it will be a little easier to control. Add a diametral dimension to this line, and set it to 1 inch. Now add a diametral dimension between this line and the construction line, and set it to 1/4 inch. You need to be aware that lines can be black and still be underdefined. For example, this line is black, and if you click it, the property manager shows that it's fully defined. But it isn't actually fully defined. Notice that I can drag the node on the end of the line to change the length. So the length of the line still needs to be specified. Add a dimension to the line and set it to 1/2 inch. Now we're going to make the node on the end of the line coincident with the vertical line. Select the line, and then hold the Control key down while you select the node. This selects both the line and the node. Now use the Property Manager to add a coincident relation to these entities. Now the node will always be aligned with the line. Add a diametral dimension to the line and the vertical construction line, and set it to 4 inches. If the lines cross, drag one of the nodes to untangle them. Now add a dimension to the horizontal line and set it to 5/8 inch. We're also going to make the length of the vertical line 1/8 inch, so add this dimension. And then add a diametral dimension from this line to the horizontal construction line. Set this dimension to 3/4 inch. Now that the sketch is fully defined, we're going to mirror the geometry on the bottom of the sketch to the top side of the horizontal construction line. We'll do this in the next lesson.